Jesus spent 3.5 years teaching 12 people. After teaching them, he said, don't attempt yet to engage what you've been taught until you are endued with power. If you attempt it, you'll be embarrassed. Power is required to make the principles work. So after teaching them for 3.5 years, they waited for 40 more days. In Acts chapter 2, the day of Pentecost, the power came. And they now began to engage the principles they've been taught. One message from one of the disciples, 3,000 people came into the kingdom. The next sermon that he preached wasn't even as long as the first one. He only performed a miracle. And people were worried, why is it, what happened, how come? And he spoke just 2 minute sermon. 5,000 people came into the kingdom. Let me tell you something. You'll be hearing principles throughout this month and also empowerment. Because God has destined your prosperity in this church. That's why he brought you here. That's why he brought you here. And for any of you who has tuned into this telecast, God also has appointed that you will watch this message and your life will be transformed. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
So brethren, I want to continue from where I stopped last week. Last week we saw the part one of this message, anointing for prosperity. We talked about prosperity mindset. Amen?
Amen.
Talk to me, brethren.
Amen.
Prosperity mindset. If you don't think right, you can never act right. Nothing happens by chance in the kingdom. Everything is programmed. God plans everything. And he began to execute them one at a time. Nothing happens by chance. God will never be taken unawares. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
And this morning we want to also look at prosperity habits. Habit. Behavior. Lifestyle. Amen?
Amen.
By the way, how many of you like to prosper? Put down your hand. If you are not prospering, can I say this? If there is no evidence of prosperity in your life, I'm sorry, you are lonely. Because people will abandon you. Even your friends will give you a distant greeting. But just begin to prosper. You will start acquiring new friends. Even people who don't know you before want to identify with you. Not because of anything, but because of that prosperity that they are seeing. Glory be to God.
Hallelujah.
So we want to look at prosperity habits. You know, habits can be adopted, can be imbibed, can be inherited. There's a way I talk. There are things I do. You could see my father in me. That's something I inherited from him. Amen?
Amen.
There are also things you emulate, you adopt by the wayside. That's why you see sometimes your eyes need to be on your children. Because when they go to school, they learn things from their peers. They learn curse words. They learn how to be arrogant, how to be rude from their peers. Which is not part of you as a parent. That's why your eyes need to be on them. Because habits can be learned over time. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
So let's take our text this morning from the book of Romans chapter 12 verse 11. We're going to see some few things today that will help you because prosperity is your portion.
Amen.
Amen. Like a portion.
Amen.
Not slothful in business, fervent in spirit, serving the Lord. Not slothful in business. God is a fine businessman. In fact, the entire kingdom of God is built on God's business model. How? He planted one son, and today God has a multitude of sons.
Amen.
That's a business model. Am I right? So God is a powerful businessman. He doesn't play with his business. He's very, very shrewd when it comes to his business. Glory be to God. So God said, not slothful in business. I'd like you to underline that word, slothful. In business. Now let's go to another chapter of the scripture. Hebrews chapter 6 verse 12. It says, and be not slothful, but followers of them who through faith and patience obtain the promise. And be not slothful,